Good afternoon, 47. Your destination is Marrakesh, Morocco, where civil riots are looming. Your targets are private banker Klaus Strandberg and army general Reza Zidane, two of the conspirators in a sinister plot to overthrow Morocco's fragile government. Strandberg, a former bank CEO who stole billions of dollars worth of savings from the Moroccan people, was facing trial for investment fraud. But early this morning, a band of heavily armed mercenaries freed Strandberg from his prison transport, resulting in the death of several police officers. Strandberg now takes refuge at his native Swedish consulate, in front of which crowds of angry protesters have gathered, demanding his handover to Moroccan authorities. We believe General Zidane orchestrated Strandberg's escape to infuriate the public and spark nationwide riots, allowing Zidane to impose martial law. Operating out of a field HQ at a nearby abandoned school, he will no doubt use the riots to depict the Rabat government as weak and inept, and persuade the general staff to support a fully-fledged military coup in the name of national security. Our client, building contractor Hamilton Lowe, who stands to lose a fortune in government contracts, has hired us to prevent the coup d'etat. To do so, you need to paralyze Zidane's rebel forces and prevent the riots from escalating further, hence the double contract. This is quite the political powder keg, 47, so be careful. The fate of a nation is at stake. I will leave you to prepare. Welcome to Marrakesh, 47. The situation grows more tense by the minute. The consulate is under lockdown, but the protests are only a stone throw away from full-blown riots, and Zidane won't hesitate to unleash his troops. So whatever you're planning, time is of the essence. Good luck, 47.
Hello there.
Strandberg is a lunatic.
No, he is capitalist. I mean, that's what we all want this day and age, right?
Not me. I'm serious. He's at the shisha den right now laughing his ass off.
Oh man, that is so like Jeff. But come on, CNN is one of the biggest news networks in the world. You can't just take their money and run.
Well, apparently they're doing an interview with Klaus Strandberg, you know, that white-collar asshole who's held up at the Swedish consulate. Well, they needed a cameraman so bad that their producer just threw some money at Jeff and forgot to ask for ID. They think his name is Finley.
But this could be like the interview of the year with GNN. Why wouldn't he just do it? Who knows where a gig like that could lead?
You know, Jeff, lazy as shit.
True that.
Right,
hello.
So what, you think they're gonna storm the place?
Oh, no, we're not barbarians.
Hi, hi, Mr. American, American.
I could just about strangle here. Stomach cramps. What kind of idiot eats shellfish from a buffet in this heat?
Relax, Pam. I hired a local cameraman. A freelance guy, he'll be fine.
Oh, well, if you're not worried, Tyler, then I'm fine. After all, it's not like this is a very important interview. I mean, it's certainly not like it's an exclusive or anything.
Pam, you remember that talk we had about low blood sugar?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this is one of those times.
Oh, so where is this guy anyway?
He'll be here. And you, have a banana, for Christ's sake.
Virginia?
Thumbs up.
You made it. Most impressive, 47. Now to locate Klaus Strandberg.
Yeah, that's good.
Massage expert Connie Engstrom reported the reception desk. That was Connie Engstrom. Please go to the reception desk.
Yeah, sure, of course. I just don't see the need for all the secrecy.
And you don't have to. Orders are orders. Look, trust me.
I don't need a security guard to feel safe. You know, I can deal with my own problems.
Normally,
I'm a big boy.
Someone, I say sorry.
Hi.
James. Hey, champ, how's it going? Oh, that's great. That's great. Is Grandma with you? Okay. I'll put Mom's on her way home, too.
That is Klaus Strandberg, most wanted man in Morocco.
Finally.
me Olander's intern, Klaus Strandberg. Did you bring the things I requested? Follow me.
Jeez.
Thirsty or scared or anything like that. How are you, sir?
Target down. Next up, Reza Zaydan.
Engstrom reported the reception desk.
That was Connie Engstrom. Please go to the reception desk.
Okay. Whatever.
Affluent Scandinavia is pilfered from the citizens of Morocco. And what is our government doing to protect us?
Hi, soldier.
How are you, recruit?
Sir, you cannot enter these premises. Keep going. Glad I made it clear to you.
Hello, Private.
What's the situation on street level?
Chanting, flagway.
Brother in arms. Salute, soldier. Only the best men. You know it.
General Zaden keeps coming down here to check on the prisoner. I hear they were close, so what'd he do, poor bastard?
The way I heard it, his brother was one of the policemen that got killed. So, he got cold feet. Got a little win on the whole operation. I hear you.
You're in. Good work, 47. Now to locate General Zaidan.
What do you do, prisoner?
Never you mind. General Zaidan is a man, a traitor, and that's all there is to it. Probably got cold feet about the operation. Try to let us out. Ask the captain.
That is General Reza Zaidan, Keeper of the Peace.
I told you to stop. I would have... advise you to do so. Are you deaf? What a...
Both targets down. Now head towards an exit.
Freeze! Don't move!
I think that we've all had enough. What keeps you up at night, yeah? Make all the demons quiet, yeah. We were built to thrive, yeah.